All right, happy Sunday. Find a seat that is comfortable and empowering. And so to distinguish comfortable and empowering is different than comfortable and sleepy. That's all, right? Like not lying down, but seated. And take a few breaths just to ground yourself in your seat. And to get your mind around what's to come, which is just meditation, yoga practice, the meditation to create awakening, presence. And the yoga practice promises power, vitality, and freedom. Pretty big promises, but that's what you will get if you commit to the work of it. After your few breaths, bring your attention to your posture. Notice your seat and feel the bones of the pelvis, left and right, the center of the pelvis, which should be space, right? So the left and the right bones ground down, the center of the pelvis is spacious, it lifts up. Lifting to the root of the spine. You allow a slight shift in the pelvis, the front of the pelvis lifts so that the spine drops down. And then from that root of the spine, lift all the way up to the crown of the head. And take a few breaths to do that. That is a lot easier said than done. Not looking for a complete blowout in the front of the ribs, just a lift from the back. If your eyes are open, your gaze is right in front of you. If your eyes are closed, then you're lifting the head so that if they were open, the gaze would be straight in front. Continue with the posture, pull your arm bones back, allowing the space in the chest to open. All the while you're breathing in and out. The breath is easy, not controlled. It's a natural ebb and flow of air. Now this posture completely created structurally in strength, space. Relax your jaw, relax the muscles of your face. Bring your attention to your hands. The hands can be a powerful expression to the outside world. Incredible tool of learning as you touch and take in. You can imagine a baby, how they have to touch everything. They're learning, imprinting. And the hands is an outward expression. You can use them for terrible things, terrible gestures, actions, and the power of touch. Touch when you support a friend. An achievement, or touch when you're supporting someone who is grieving. Acknowledge the hands and the power they hold. And that's it. I want you to stay in your posture, the length in the spine, grounding in the seat. Breath flowing in and out. Relaxing your jaw. And acknowledging all the power you have in your hands. For the next bit, just deepen your breath in and out. If you're with somebody, allow them to hear the breath move. Let your eyes open, draw your hands to your chest. And thumbs to forehead, namaste. Awesome. Shift your body into child's pose. And now in child's pose, we're going to add a consciousness to the breath. It's ujjayi breath. It is a breath that is really driven by the diaphragm, but you will inhale deeply through your nose. Fill the chest, and then you'll gently exhale through the nose. And this breath is continual, breathing in and breathing out. When we do breath work, we will focus on that space between the inhale and exhale, but I'm not asking you to hold your breath. Just to acknowledge that there is a space between the inhale and exhale as it transitions. And if you are someone who tends to hold your breath under stress or when you're caught up in thought, I'm going to ask you to work on the continuum of the breath, right? And if you need that pause at the top, then take it. Downward facing dog. You're creating roots with your hands and your feet. Your feet come straight out of your natural pelvis, so not feet so wide that they're where your skin is, right? But not touching. There's a natural pelvis. You look at your femur bones, your thigh bones, and they come straight out, then knees, then feet. And breathe. So Alex and the trio, I think your dogs are a little bit short. Maybe walk your feet back or your hands forward. You want to get to that place where you can kind of even your weight out. Yeah, and there's a natural place where the head drops down in down dog. See the powerful pose, pressing through the hands and the feet, driving energy up into the pelvic floor. and you're moving the breath. The next tool is gaze. Your eyes are open. And I want you to pick a spot at the back of your mat right now that you see. And you'll want to invite yourself back to the spot every time you can see that spot. So in forward folds, down dog, whenever you can see it, headstand. Gently walk your feet to meet your hands. Take your feet a little wider this time, like shoulder width, or even wider, lengthen your spine. And hang into ragdoll. You'll interlace your hands and make a basket. Draw the basket forward, drawing the upper body forward. If you're grabbing the mat with your toes, lift your toes and separate them. Keep the breath moving. Your gaze should be the same as it was in down dog. Take a deep breath in. Right here, open your mouth, a slow exhale. Now close your mouth and breathe. Drop your hands. Heel toe the feet back in, straight out of the pelvis. Lengthen your spine. Fold. Rise all the way up, extended mountain press through the feet, lift up. Take a deep breath in. Gently fold forward over your legs. Lengthen your spine, inhale. You're gonna step it back into a low push-up. And then upward dog and downward dog. Breathe in and breathe out. Step to your hands. Lift. Fold. Press down, rise up. Nice. Fold forward. Exhale. Lift and lengthen your spine, inhale. Low push up, exhale. Use your breath. Upward dog, shoulders go straight back. Beautiful. Downward dog, exhale. Nice, inhale. Exhale, step to your hands. Lengthen your spine. Lengthen your spine is at this halfway lift. Is really akin to a deadlift. So your shoulders will lift, your head stays neutral, you're pressing into the feet, tailbone goes back, inhale, and then fold. All the way up, extended mountain, you're pressing through the feet, spine is straight, and then exhale, forward fold. Start to move with flow of the breath. Lift and lengthen the spine. Step or jump back, low push up. Upward dog, shoulders back. Down dog, exhale. In breath. Out breath, step forward. Lift your spine. Fold. Press down, rise up. Fold forward, exhale. Lengthen. Low push up. Up dog. Down dog. Inhale. Exhale, step forward. Lift and fold all the way up, reach. Fold down, exhale. Lengthen. Low push up. Up dog. Down dog, set your gaze and breathe. Our intention with our sun salutations is to awaken, to connect the breath to the movement, to set your sights on a practice that will move you and create space, a practice that will calm your mind and your spirit. Empty your air. Step or jump forward. Lengthen your spine. Fold in. We're going to go to a chair. The feet stay straight out of the pelvis. Arms reach. There's this driving force in your knees, almost like there's a force field. You're internally rotating your thighs and your legs are like staying together, but you're pulling apart with your feet. So it becomes very active in the quads. Inhale. Take your seat lower. Nice. Breathe in. Fold. Lift. Low push-up. Up dog. Down dog. Right foot steps, warrior one. You inhale to raise up, come up. Nice. Now set the pose. You want weight equally in both feet. So you want to feel the back foot as you press into the heel. Feel the front foot as you press into the ball mound in the center of the heel. Pull your femur back. You're deep in a lunge, like your thigh nearly parallel. See if you can go low enough that the matchbox car doesn't roll down. Good luck with that too. Breathe in. Low push up. Nice, Macy. Upward dog. Downward dog. Left side, warrior one. I'm going to ask you to start using your arms for a tool too. You're pressing through the feet. Legs are like working a lot, pulling back on the left femur, pulling the right femur in. And then your arms, this is the tool. You reach up, you're expanding the side bodies. You're opening the rib cage to deepen the breath. Inhale. And then exhale, your arms will come down as you compress the chest, lower, and then inhale up. Arms are straight again, pulling back. Exhale, down dog. Breath in. And you breathe out, step forward. Lift and lengthen. Fold. Chair pose, your arms lift, breathe in. And then fold, exhale. Lift, arms are long. Chaturanga, exhale. Upward dog, inhale. Exhale, down dog. Use the end of that breath, right foot steps. Inhale, go up, but your arms lift to expand the chest. And then exhale down. Upward dog. Downward facing dog. Left side, warrior one. Nice, come back down. Low push up, chaturanga. Up dog. And downward facing dog. I want you to know at any time in this practice that you need to do something different than what I'm saying, you do it. So child's pose is the way that we tap out for a minute, catch our breath, relax the body, reset. Also electing to hold a downward facing dog would work, coming to your knees or staying in standing. All those are great resets. If you need them, you take a breath in. And breath out, step or jump forward. Lift. Fold. Chair. Fold forward. Lengthen your spine. Chaturanga. Upward dog. Downward dog. Use your breath. Right foot steps, warrior one. Kick it right back down. Low push up. Up dog and downward facing dog. Left side, warrior one. The most important part is breath. Breathe in and breathe out. So if at any point in time you take a break, you stay breathing with this, with the sangha, with the class, downward facing dog. Inhale together. It's a nice reset. Exhale. Step or jump forward. Lengthen, fold, chair, use your arms, fold forward, lengthen your spine, Low push up. Up dog. Down dog. Warrior one, right foot. Beautiful, low push up. Up dog. Shoulders back. Down dog. Left side, warrior one. And low push up. Up dog. Downward facing dog. Breathe. This practice is a continuum. There's no end point. Right? There's an end point to this particular class. But there's no end point to the practice. And some days we're stronger than others. Some days we're less sore than others. Breathe in, lift your right leg up. Then you're going to bend your knee, go hip over hip. Stay right here and breathe. So what I'm asking you to do is you honor your body where it is. From here, you can come to the ball mound of your left foot, lifting way up. Bend your left knee. Take your right foot, step it right next to the left and flip over, flip dog. You could hold the stretch. Nice, we'll all meet up in downward facing dog. And then we're gonna powerfully turn to side plank, right arm goes down. You have some options to drop your bottom knee. One of my favorite is take the front leg and the top leg in front and press down and lift up. It gives you the length in the side. It helps you build strength. This practice should test your strength, but it shouldn't take you over the edge. Breathe in and then low push up. Up dog. Downward facing dog. I had somebody tell me that they were afraid to take this class because it was going to be too hard. It can be, right? Lift your left leg. But it doesn't have to be. It's only as hard as you make it. Open hip over hip. So you take the time where you need the time. You stay in with breath. Every pose can be changed or modified up to the ball mound of your right foot. Soften your knee, flip the dog. I want you to listen to your body. Deepen your breath. Beautiful. We're going to meet in downward facing dog. And then we're going to turn to side plank, left arm down. Remember options. You can drop the bottom knee. You can take the top leg across and press down, which is my favorite. You could lift a leg. I'm not going to encourage that right now. I'm going to ask you to stay in the general form of the pose. Bring your head and neck in a line and look up. And then low push up. Up dog. Downward facing dog. And I just want to know, are you awake? Did the practice work? Lift your right leg up and step your foot through for crescent lunge. We're going to move into vitality, feeling alive, right? Feeling your body where it is, sensations. Staying attuned to the practice with gaze, drishti, and breath. And even if you take a break, stay with gaze and breath. Twisting or revolving crescent lunge, hands come to the chest. You're going to twist over your front leg. Elbow can lock on the thigh. If balance is awkward, you can drop your back knee. You can take a hand down to the inside, which gives you an extra point to hold on to. All the while, ujjayi breath moving. If you've lost it, bring it back. One more. Empty your air. Come up and around, warrior two. First warrior two, may feel a little wonky at first. Set it up, heels in one line, thigh becoming parallel. Let's give a reverse. I'm gonna straighten the front leg for a little relief for those of us who like lots of exercise. And come right back. Extended side angle lunge. At its basic shape, your forearm is on your thigh, pressing into both feet, and the left arm will rise. Options, you can take your hand down. I like the outside of my front foot on a block. Pay attention to unscrunch your toes. Press through both legs. Gaze up and breathe. So when you have an intentionality of your gaze where your eyes go, that focus creates focus everywhere else. Takes you out of the monkey brain or the circus brain. But in all honesty, we spend too much time in. Full breath in. You're gonna take your left arm down, right hand down, step back, little push up. Up dog. Down dog. Diligence with breath. Lift your left leg up. You're gonna bring your knee into your chest, slide forward, crescent lunge. If you're fully extended, knee not down, you actually want your leg straight, but you're lifting with the back of the thigh. You're not locking your knee out. And you're gonna lift the front of the pelvis a little bit, lengthen the spine. Breath gazes forward so far. You're gonna revolve, hands to chest, twist with the upper back. Remember, you can take your hand down to the floor if that gives you more stability. You can drop your knee again. None of those things are cop-outs, right? I want you to challenge your body where your body wants to be challenged. And I also want you to acknowledge work you've done and what the body needs today. Stay with breath. Your gaze is up to the ceiling. One more. Empty it out. Open it up, warrior two. We'll have the same option on this side. So set the pose with a nice deep knee bend. And then you're going to reverse it. And this is where we can straighten the leg for space. And I don't know about you, but this feels really good to me. And then extended side angle again. Forearm to your thigh. Nice. Or all the way down, outside of your foot on a block. You're doing that to create that abduction, outward pressing of your left leg. Your right leg is straight, pressing through the entire surface area of the right foot. Get in, breathe. Ideally, had a neck in line looking up. If that's painful on your neck for any reason, you just shift it to your left big toe. Deepen your breath. Stay in with the energy in your feet. One more. And take it down. Right hand, left hand, left foot back. Low push up. Up dog. Down dog. Take a deep breath in. Empty your air. Step or float, forward. Lengthen your spine. Fold. Go to chair. You're gonna revolve, prayer twist right. Macy, I won't hold it long. Come on in, yeah. Draw your knees in just a hair, Mace. Breath and fold. Take your feet out, lengthen your spine, and fold. Heels to the feet back in. Lengthen your spine, inhale. Exhale and fold. Use your in-breath chair. Hands to chest, revolve left. So the beauty of teaching this class and being able to see you is that my goal is to teach to you, not some arbitrary, invisible group, but to you. Fold forward, walk your feet out. This time you're gonna step on your hands. So palms up, fingertips reach for the back of your foot while the toes reach for the wrist. Lengthen and then pull down for gorilla. And my goal is to see you, to emulate what you need based on what I'm seeing in you. And I do want to push you a little bit, it's true. But I really just want you to walk up to that edge and then stop. Okay, heel toe the feet in, lengthen your spine. The next pose is crow. If you don't know crow, you can just watch. But basically, you're going to take your hands about the same distance as you do for your little push-up. You're going to bring your feet to touch. Knees will come out. Your knees will reach for your armpits. You're going to lay your shin bones on your upper arm bones. You're going to squeeze and hug in and lift your feet up. Okay, so I'll try it, crow. 5, 4, just prepping is great. 3, 2, okay, feet down. Take your feet wide, do a yoga squat. Whew. Well done, Alex. So yoga squat, yeah, feet are wide. You're taking your tailbone to the floor. Lengthening your spine. So if you're all hunchy, see if you can get a block under your seat and get long in the spine and set your gaze forward. And this is like a timeout. This is a yogi timeout. So gaze forward. So with your palms pressing, you want to pull your shoulders back more. Beautiful. Breathe. Nice. Take your hands to the floor. You're going to heel toe the feet in. Lengthen the spine. Bow. Rise all the way up, extended mountain. You're gonna wrap up for eagle. The right arm goes under, the left leg goes over. Squeeze and hug in. And reach up. Make sure your gaze is set to one point, left side. So you don't shift the gaze. You're not going to look at your feet. You're not going to look all around your space. You're going to keep it set forward. In breath. All the way out breath. And reach up. Right arm. Extended mountain. The intention here, left arm, is to give you a tool, a set of tools to calm yourself in the midst of whatever storm or chaos is around you. Extended mountain. And then hands to your chest and to your hips. You're going to lift your right leg. You can keep the knee bent. Gaze still stays forward, or you can fully extend your leg, pulling both shoulders onto your back. And it's in front of you still. Yeah, just try it on. Press more down into your left leg. Keep your gaze steady. Take it out to the right. Left arm out. And breathe. You got it. Breathe. Now here's the trick. Bring it back to the center, and then send it back airplane. Airplane is your arms are extended. You really are making an airplane with your upper body. Palms down. Back foot is turning toward the earth. You're pressing through the left foot to lift the left pelvis up even with the right. Deep breathing. Hands to chest, pause. And then the easiest transition here is to go over your front leg, take both hands down to the floor. If you have a block, use it. If not, don't. Your left hand is going to stay down. You're going to peel your body open for half moon. Stay focused with breath and gaze. And don't concern yourself with falling out. Falling out is actually a natural part of walking up to your edge. You don't know what your edge is if you always stop 100 yards back. One more breath. Nice. Right foot will come down and rise up. Extended mountain. Beautiful job. And then hands come through your heart and to your hips and left leg up. Macy, I don't know how all those people can walk by and not join you. It's so much, looks like you're having so much fun. So Macy chooses a corridor at college and then open it out. And why everybody's up and not doing yoga, I don't know. Breathe. But for her, this practice is real right now, right? Like she is working to calm the breath to stay in the practice with all those people walking by. And stay focused, come back to the center. So she's real life practicing this. And go into airplane. Like for me, it's easy. It's just me in my room. No distractions. They've locked the dogs away for a bit. They're in doggy jail. My child is at a sleepover. I mean, you know, I've got it easy. But if I didn't have it easy, if I had the distractions, hands to chest, I have the tools. Breath, fold over your standing leg, gaze. My foundation, core, hands and feet, plant your right arm, spin open. The pelvis, creating the stability. As you come into your half moon, if you can start to shift your gaze up. If you come out, you just start over, over and over and over again. And then feet down. Lengthen your spine. Fold in. If you have a strap, grab it. You're going to reach up, extended mountain. So if you don't have a strap, you're just using your hand. So for those without a strap, you're taking your right arm behind you like you're holding a pizza tray. You're going to catch your right foot, keeping your hips as square as possible, and then gently lift up. Yeah. The strap, I think, makes the pose way easier. So if you practice regularly, you should get a strap. Three. Nice. Two. Nice. Last breath. Switch sides. You're just going to plant your feet again. If you're going to catch your left foot, either in the strap or in your hand. Press through your right foot and lift up. You're trying to, whether this you have a strap or not, you're trying to get both shoulders onto your back. Keep your gaze forward, inhale and exhale. Three. You got it, just come back. Two. Last breath. And set it down. Right side, another opportunity. They usually use the analogy of pancakes. Like you make the first pancake and it's no good, so you throw it up. And then you make the second one's always better. I don't know if that's really true. There is neuromuscular memory though, right? So the second one should be a little easier to balance. But then you want to push your edge just a little further. One more breath. Nice, switch sides. Stay in. If possible, stay in with breath. With drishti focus, breathing in and out. Just come back again. And release. Stand in your feet. Shoulders pull back. And bring your right foot up for tree. Hands at chest. Stay in with breath. Visual focus. And release, left side. Andrea, I think you need to install a bar. I think a bar would be the best addition to your room. Well, maybe a Peloton bike and a bar. Oh, good. Beautiful, release. Set your gaze again, hands by your side. Take a big breath in and reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale and lengthen your spine. And then exhale, chaturanga, low push-up. Up dog, shoulders back. Downward facing dog, breathe out. Immediately, right foot steps forward. It's warrior one. You can go up and back here. And then open warrior two. Near the last training I went to, Baron said, the grounding sequence is in the middle of the practice. This is where we are. He said, it's a restart. No matter what's going on, this is like the begin again. Ground down to lift up. You can reverse your warrior and straighten your front leg and go into triangle pose. So focus on roots to rise, pressing into both feet, your right hand, pulling the thighs into the pelvis, lengthen your spine, and breathe. And no matter what's happened before now, just be right here. You bend your front knee and come up. Choose any arm variation you wish. Turn your toes in, right toes in. Lengthen your spine. Fold into wide-legged straddle. Lift halfway. Pull your shoulders onto your back. Rise up. Make a reverse prayer, reverse namaste with your hands. Let me take some doing. Pull both shoulders onto your back. The more integrated your shoulders, the easier this is. And then rotate your feet for pyramid. So it's a reverse namaste forward fold. Feet come, they're pelvic width, not one on top of the other. The mistake is usually to line them up too narrow and there's no space. So take them hip width, tailbone back, crown forward. Breath. Breath in and out. Nice. Take your hands down. Lengthen your spine. And you're going to twist your triangle. So left hand stays down. Press through the feet and rise up. Good. Breathe and breathe. One more breath in. Both hands come down to the floor. You'll step your right leg back, left leg back, lower down, low push up, upward dog, shoulders back, downward dog, breathe out. Left foot steps, warrior one. Open to two. And pause, and just set this pose. Your gaze generally is forward over your left hand, unless that's really uncomfortable, you can go straight. And then go into triangle with your breath. Inhale and reverse if you wish. And then exhale, reach, 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 reach. From the roots of your hands and feet, you open up, right arm will reach to the sky. You create length in your spine. Tailbone goes back, crown of your head forward, head and neck neutral. So try not to let the head and neck just drop. Breathe. Nice, empty. You can bend your front knee. Take the reverse namaste with your hands. Shift your feet for pyramid. Lengthen your spine. Fold. If reverse namaste is not accessible, any link behind your back will be great. And drop your hands to the floor. Find a block inside or outside of your right foot. Press down, tailbone back, crown forward, and then open, spin open in the twist. Stay grounded in both feet. Work the tailbone back. One more breath. And empty it out, both hands down. Left foot goes back. High plank, hold. Press down into your hands, press out with your hands. Press into the thumb and the forefinger like you're twisting your jar lid on. One more breath here. Lower down, 5, 4, 3, 2, all the way down. Turn one ear down. Turn the other ear down. Center your chin on the mat. Take your hands by your side, palms down. Shoulders will lift. You can press into your fingertips if you wish. You can press into your feet if you wish. Take an exhale and then lift up. Upper back lifting you. You can lift your feet. This is locust. 3, 2, last breath. You're gonna drop down, exhale. Re-engage pelvic floor, lift up again. This time bend your knees, catch your ankles or feet. Keep your knees hip width, lift up, bow. Listen. Release the bow into locust, floor. One breath in and out. From here, bend your knees, catch your ankles. And with the power of your thighs, lift up, floor bow. And down. Place your hands low on your rib line. Press through the tops of your feet, elbows on your back, and lift up. Up dog. One more breath here. Go to down dog. Drop your knees. Get your spine long. Press down from belly button down as roots. You can take your shoulders on your back, so integrate them. Then you can bring your arms to your hands to your seat. You're going to press your seat down, not forward, but down, and then open the chest. Let your head and neck drop if they're ready. You can walk your hands down to your shins or your feet. One more breath. Empty slowly up. Have a seat on your feet. Get a drink. Set your gaze forward. How are we holding up? Good. recommit to the remaining part of the practice. The backbending series is really meant to energize you, right? And so we're going to commit to the energy that it takes to complete that. Trust the process. Come up. Camel number two. Do what you need to do with your upper body to integrate it. Five, four, three, two, and one. All the way up. Nice. And now turn your feet around. You're just going to go to bridge pose. You can turn your feet, come over on your seat, kind of line yourself up before you go back into bridge. Make sure that your feet are coming right out of your own pelvis and steer them straight at 12 o'clock and then take your spine to the floor. Press down into your feet. You can even press down into your upper arm bones and lift up. In fact, pressing into your upper arm bones gives you probably a little bit more integration than length in the pose. Ujjayi breath. And this is a great tool. You can look at your own rib cage and watch the breath move. You'll see a rise and a stretch, and then you'll see a fall and a squeezing in. And gently roll your back down to the mat. Good. Check in with your feet again. If they splayed out, you want to just reach down and make sure they're square. Breath in and breath out. Press down, draw in, go up, bridge. If it's in your practice or you want to try it on today, or take your hands wide near your ears, you're going to press into your hands and lift up into wheel. You can start with your head on the mat, draw your shoulders in, and then press up. And then gently come down. Breathe in and breathe out. Go back up, bridge. And if you're going to wheel, go in now. Come down. Good, again, bridge. Yeah, there's always the option to hold the wheel. Go to wheel. Go up. If it's in your practice, go up. Alex, walk your hands out a little bit so they're a little bit more liberating in your wrists. They got to the sides. Good. Breathe. Nice, Macy. Tuck your chin. Come down. Good. Take a breath here. Empty your air out. Press down on your feet. Go up, bridge. Go up. Right now. Add your arms, wheel. Take it all the way. All the way. If you've got it, do it. Five, four, three, two, come down. Guess what? I'm going to give you one more opportunity. Take a big breath in. Empty it out. Press down, go up. Bridge. Add your arms. If you can, you should. And do wheel. Three. Come on, you've got it in you. Two. Press down. Big breath in. All the way to the floor. Soles of your feet together, knees out for butterfly. Well done. That was beautiful. It was beautiful if you did bridge. It was beautiful if you did wheel because you were listening to your body, not your head. You weren't listening to the narrative that can't do or the narrative that has to do something to prove something. You're just listening to you. Like, this will be good for me right now. Bring your knees into your chest. And do happy baby. You're going to grab either your big toes or the outer edges of your feet. You pull your thighs toward the mat, lengthen your spine, case four, graze up. And stay in breath. My disempowering narrative used to be, this can't be good for me. I used to say that in my head. And then, of course, it wasn't. So listen to the body instead of the narrative. Bring your knees in. You're going to tuck and hold your legs. It's a nice little ball. And then we're going to stabilize our spine after the opening. Lift your legs to the ceiling. Take your hands and interlace them behind your head. You're going to press your head into your hands. Yeah, so it's not so much about where your elbows land. In fact, I like your elbows neutral, but press your head into your hands. Legs will reach. So there's not just lifted and limp, like you're reaching through your feet. And you're going to curl up so the ribs come closer to the pelvis. Head and neck stay neutral. You're pressing your head back into your hands. You're going to lower your right leg. Stay right here. Keep lifting and breathing. How about gaze on your right big toe? Nice. Now shift your feet, left toe down. So now your gaze is on your left big toe. Hold. Switch. Hold. Low back pressing into the floor. Switch. Hold. Keep curling up. You feel your shoulder blades hit the floor. Curl up again. Switch. 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 Switch, 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 pause up. Bend your knees, 90 degree angle. Take your elbow and reach for the outside edge of your left knee. Straighten your right leg. Switch. Yoga bicycles are slow. Switch. Intentional. Switch. Switch. Try not to let your thigh come closer to your chest than parallel. Switch. Switch. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stop. Knees are right where they were. Take your hands underneath your low back. Extend your legs up. Lower your legs 1/3 of the way. Pause. Your head and neck are on the floor now. 2/3. Pause. Take them to a hover. You're just going to look at your toes. So keep your chest down. Breathe. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Up. Everything down your head, your head, neck, and back are on the floor. Lower your legs 1/3, 2/3. Hover. Look at your toes. Curl, draw from the ribs to the pelvis. 5, 4, 3, 2, up. Take your hands and reach them towards the front of your mat. Tilt into boat pose, Navasana. You can hold the back of your legs. I do this outer shin where I press out and press in. It helps me stabilize and I can get longer. 5, 4, 3, 2, low boat. Peel up, high boat. Rock and roll to downward facing dog. Down dog. Oh, the sun is coming up in your space, Brooke. It's beautiful. You sun salutationed it right up. Go to half pigeon, right leg forward. And now we're going to release. We're actually going to open. We're going to open the hips. Imagine there's no heaven. There is some release in it, but it's opening.
It's easy if you try.
You've warmed the body, and the body's finally ready to create some opening.
No hell below us.
I compare the first 3/4 of this practice to training puppies. First, you have to exhaust yourself. And then once you're exhausted, you can allow for opening and release.
For today, you may say that I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one.
I have about 3 more breaths. If you need to change anything, change it now.
You'll join us. and the world will live as one. Imagine there's no countries.
And then gently transition to the other side. Transition any way you want to. You can just flip it around, or you can go through down dog and pause for a second.
Nothing to kill or die for. No religion.
Just stay in breath. And your drishti will sometimes close when you're in the opening sequence. So if your eyes naturally close, let that happen. But see if you can stay in the practice. See if you can stay away from making a list of what you need to do. See if you can stay in breath. And feel the feels in your body. Breathe into the tight crevices.
I hope someday you'll join
release
us.
Release the jaw again.
In the world,
if there's tension in your shoulders or your hands, release it.
Imagine no possessions. I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger.
Last three breaths.
A brotherhood of man. Imagine all the people.
And this time you're going to sit up. You're going to bring your back leg around.
All the world.
I'm going for double pigeon. Your thigh bones are going to come straight out of your natural pelvis, so they tend to be a little bit at an outward angle,
but I'm not the only
not quite square.
I hope someday.
So if this is really tight for you, you're going to find that your right knee like lifts all the way up. If you're really open, your right knee is going to drop, and if it does, then you can actually start to fold forward and change where this pose is working. And then transition to the other side any way you wish. I like to transition through boat, it's not mandatory.
I guess I just feel like nobody's honest, nobody's true. Everyone's lying to make it on through. I guess I just feel like I'm the same way too.
Okay, we're gonna go into frog. If frog is not really accessible to you because of audience or space, then you can do another happy baby. But frog, you will, and the trio can just stagger, I think. But you can just take your legs out. Start with everything stacked, hips over knees. Knees and shin bones stacked, ankles right under it, and you'll walk your torso down and gradually let your thighs go to the sides.
It's too much to take on.
Macy, you know, Tanya does that thing where the diamond is longer and she folds down, do you know what I mean? Yeah, that. And then she kind of wraps her arms around her legs and pulls in. Yeah. Deepen your breath. Let your eyes close. Last 10 breaths.
I guess I just feel like the joke's getting old. The future is fading, and the past is on hold. But I know that I'm open, and I know that I'm free, and I'll always let hope in wherever I'll be. And if I go blind, I'd still find my way. I guess I just felt like giving up today.
You'll gently bring yourself out of this pose. We'll meet on our seat. Extend your left leg, tuck your right foot into your left thigh. And a big reach up, and then fold over your left leg. Releasing any tension left in your low back, your hamstring, your hips, breathe. Switch sides. Center, both legs out, big reach, hold. Take your hands behind you, plant your feet. It's reverse tabletop or plank. You can extend your legs if you wish. Open up, let go, breathe. Tongue out, drop down. Take your, you've got two choices here, either waterfall or shoulder stand. You take your legs up, hands to your low back. You're gonna stack your feet, your femurs, right over your shoulders as much as you can. So from hips up straight, walking your arms under to reach higher on your back. If you're doing waterfall, your legs are just up on the block and you're breathing. Start to ease your way into plow. Drop your knees close to your ears, ear pressure pose. And then a very gentle roll out. Give your knees a squeeze. Hold on to your right leg, extend your left leg. Pull your right leg across your body for a twist. Let the breath deepen and find some ease in it. Come back to center. Squeeze in. Extend your right leg. Take your left leg across. Back to center. One more squeeze in. Then put your feet together and knees out for another butterfly. Let your eyes close. when you're ready, you want to extend your legs for Shavasana. Get your eyes closed. Full body rest for just a few moments. Check in with your jaw. Allow the breath to be easy. You are, just deepen your breath.
She travels outside.
Let's see if you can get the breath to move your entire body.
She travels outside.
And then bring your knees into your chest.
And
gently roll to your side. Gratitude.
Grace finds beauty.
Gratitude for what you are capable of. Gratitude for being able to share your practice with others.
Grace. She carries a world on her hips. No champagne flute for her lips. No twirls or skips between her fingers.
Your seat.
What once was
hurt. Dance your heart.
Once was friction. What left a mark.
Bumps your forehead. Namaste. was trying to be fancy and control the volume with my phone, and it quit working. It worked for a minute.